Now, to all the veterans here with us today, we thank you for your service. At this time, please welcome Ben Salem High School Marine Corps Junior ROTC for the presentation of colors.
Detail. Oh, and cut.
Cut.
Present. R.
Present.
And Lord, we ask you to continue to bless us. Bless our veterans who are serving today. And thank you for all the men and women who have served over the many, many years. We are so grateful for living in this wonderful land. Be with us during this holiday season that we can feel your presence. We thank you, God, for all that you're doing in our life. We thank thee in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Good morning. Are you out there? Good morning. All right, let's start by doing some jumping jacks. We did this in the Marine Corps. It kept us warm. Are you ready? Good morning, everybody. Right now, I'd just like to ask every veteran to raise their hand. Every veteran that's out here now, raise your hand. All those that didn't raise your hand, give them a round of applause. We thank them. Good morning, my fellow Americans. We are here this morning to pay homage to all the brave women and men that have donned the uniform of the United States veteran. No matter what branch, whether it be the Marine Corps, the Army Guard, the Navy, the Air Force, or the Coast Guard, we pay them the highest honor of our respect today, as we should do every day. A great number of Americans take for granted the cost that is paid for us to live the way we do in this country. Not all of us live the same type of lifestyles as one another, but we can all say that we have the privilege and freedom to do so many things that other nations and countries do not have access to do. And it is only because of the United States veteran. One freedom out of many freedoms that we do have is a freedom to worship how we see fit. This is an inalienable right guaranteed to us by the Constitution. Even though some of us fight to take this right away, it is certain the veterans of the United States have fought to protect the right to worship how we please. But because of the brave men and women of our military, we once again do not live in fear. Some quotes. It was once said that America without veterans is like God without his angels. That flag above, it doesn't fly because of the wind. It flies with the last breath of each veteran who died protecting it.
The Michael Strange Foundation is dedicated to serving those gold stars. This foundation supplies grief counseling and the fellowship and support of other gold star families. A gathering of gold star families each year allows new and old families to learn how to process their loss, share their loss with others who truly understand such grief, and begin healing process together as a team, as a family. Like their sons and daughters, they know they are not alone. Please welcome Charlie Strange.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for coming out. Bearing the cold, and see the Cub Scouts over there. God bless you. Start doing some push-ups. Mother started doing push-ups when he was in seventh grade. Then he started throwing them off the steps. My name's Charles Strange. I'm a Gold Star father. My son was killed in action August 6, 2011, along with 30 other brave Americans embarked the war dog. Like my friend said, it was the biggest loss of life in Iraq and Afghanistan. It was the biggest loss of life in the history of America. 22 of them guys were from Navy Special Warfare. We're from Philadelphia. Michael went to North Catholic. We used to run the Rocky Steps before he got in. Michael would run home. He'd beat me. I'd be in the car. He joined the military. He was looking for to get some money for college. I didn't want him to join the military, to be true and honest with you. And after he did us, there you go, and he took off. 21 years old, he was in Hawaii. He was a cryptologist, a code breaker. They gave him the National Intelligence Medal of Valor. Only 17 been given out in the history of America since the Wind Talkers in WW2. We knew Michael was smart, we didn't know he was that smart. He was on SEAL Team 6, the gold team. His call sign was GY4, Gold Yankee 4. He loved the military, he loved what he did, he loved defending our freedoms. Michael and his friends killed some of the people that were here in our country that were going to do harm to us. April 2011, my son called me. He said, "Dad, you're not going to hear from me for 2 weeks. I said, "What's going on, Michael? What's the matter, Michael? You worry about your children, right?" He said, "Well, Dad, if something happens, you'll hear about it." May 2nd, he was part of killing Osama bin Laden. Yeah. Michael was the guy when they were going in to kill bin Laden that was hanging out the side of the helicopter. He came home from that, and he was different. Something was going on. And 93 days later was the worst day of our life when they knocked on the door. You know, I was out of my mind, and I met Gold Star mom and dad from Bernath and Grant and Kim Smith, and I came home to my wife who's sitting behind me. I said, "Them people are just like me. They're ready to go to the hat factory. Michael's just sitting here. He's 25 years old." And that's how we started the Michael Strange Foundation. Please check us out on Facebook and YouTube. Hear some of the testimonies. We've done 12 weekends. We brought over 350 Gold Star families in for 3 nights and 4 days. We pay for the hotel, the food, the plane ticket. Since some of the saying they say, ultimate sacrifice. When my son's helicopter got hit by the RPG, he jumped out of the helicopter and he was like this. He was alive for 15 minutes with a gun in his hand. His ankle was almost over. That's my nightmare. Christine Koch from North Jersey, her Gold Star mother, came to our weekend. 18 months later, her daughter, who they took to a psychologist twice, said, "I'm going to go be with my brother," and took a handful of pills and killed herself. Steve and Donna Folks from South Carolina, Marines. Son was shot and killed in Afghanistan. 12 months later, his brother, drinking and driving, missing his brother, killed himself. Mrs. Johnson from Virginia, whose son was killed in Afghanistan, yells up to her son, "Yo, I'm going to the store. You need anything?" "I'm going to be all right, Mom. I don't need anything." Shoots himself and kills himself. The freedom is not free. We lost 303 in Pennsylvania, Iraq, and Afghanistan. I suffer every day. Don't matter how many children you have. People come up, "What's a Gold Star?" People go, "Oh, congratulations, you're a Gold Star father." People don't know. Gold Star means you lost someone you love killing in action. A Blue Star, if you see a Blue Star, that means they have someone serving in the military. I cannot thank everybody enough for Wreaths Across America, all you people coming out here. This means our sons didn't die twice. You understand what I mean? Do not forget, freedom is not free. We want our sons and daughters to be remembered. They didn't die in vain. You know, 20 years in Afghanistan, we're the strongest military in the world. You know, I've been spoken out, I speak out about a lot of different things, and what helps me the most is meeting the other families that lost a son and daughter in Iraq and Afghanistan. And my man over here with the camera, Patrick Hughes, always shows up and puts us out. I can't thank Patrick, Vietnam veteran. I can't thank everybody enough here. You know how much this means to me to see that people do care? I can't thank you enough, as Gold Star families. And God bless America. God bless you all here. Merry Christmas. And thank you so much for inviting me and my family.
Today we honor, are here to honor all those who have been laid to rest at Washington's Crossing Cemetery. Every person laid to rest here has a brother or sister to his left or right, all brothers in arms. Presentation of 8 ceremonial wreaths by 8 of our local veterans. These men and women represent each branch of service, and they too are brothers in arms. Each wreath represents a branch of the armed services of the United States. Army, Navy, Marines, Air Force, Coast Guard, and Space Forces. The 7th wreath represents the Merchant Marines. And the 8th wreath represents the more than 81,600 POWs, MIAs for wars throughout the history. Ceremonial wreath presenters, Dave Pearl, Master Sergeant, Retired Air Force. Sean Wharton, Master Sergeant, Retired Marine Corps. Walter Roddenberger, Army Sergeant. Tim Eisling, Army Sergeant. Joe Schellenberger, Senior Master Sergeant, Retired Air Force. Fernando Teledon, Army Sergeant. Chris Knoll, Army. Bill Sims, Navy Retired Chief. Please let us have a moment of silence for all those who rest here in every cemetery across the United States. Today we lay wreaths here to be sure these heroes are not forgotten. Bueller, sound taps.